Okay, ladies, let's talk postpartum depression. So, I am almost 2 months out of having my baby. If you guys haven't seen my labor and delivery video, go ahead and check that out. I will put a little link somewhere on the screen so you guys can go ahead and take a look at that. But on a real note and serious note, you guys, postpartum depression is no joke. With my son, I didn't really experience it. So much stuff was going on after I had him. Like, I was in the process of moving and I was living with my family. There were so many people around me all the time. I didn't really realize if I've had postpartum depression with him. But with my daughter, I've been experiencing postpartum depression. I know it hasn't been to its full capability on what it could be because the power of the Lord is strong, you guys. I'm going to just kind of talk about what I've been experiencing and how I've been overcoming it because postpartum depression is no joke. And one of my subbies, a good friend of mine now, her name is Keisha. She actually requested this video, so thank you, girl, for requesting it. It's something that definitely needs to be talked about because not enough women are discussing it. And when you're at the hospital, they kind of just brush over it. They don't really go in depth on the topic. So, me and my experience on postpartum depression, what I've been experiencing is just a loneliness, kind of like not regret, because I don't regret my kids, but the coulda, woulda, shoulda factor. Like, dang, if I didn't have kids, I could be doing this. I wish, you know, I would. Like, I could possibly have this job opportunity, this and that, because there's been so many opportunities that have come my way, but I can't take them because I have kids, I breastfeed, my babies are so little, and it's just like, dang, only if I didn't have this baby, I could do this and do that. And then I'm in my house like 24 hours of the day, so it's just like, all you see is your walls, you're not talking really to anybody. I mean, unless you have other people that are just like texting and calling you or visiting. And I kind of have that, but then for the most part, I'm like, I'm a person who kind of stays to myself most of the time. So I guess that's not very healthy, especially when you are going through this. I don't really talk to people about it because, you know, fear of being judged and so on and so forth. And you probably, I don't know, but how I've been dealing with my depression is, in the morning, I first and foremost, even if I forget, once I wake up and open my eyes, some part during my morning, I will start praying. Like, if I forget to pray, I'm just like, oh, let me stop whatever I'm doing. If I'm making oatmeal, I close my eyes in front of that stove. I'm like, Lord, this is my prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord God, I thank you for waking me up this morning. I thank you for watching over us and protecting us, Lord God. I ask that you let my day be not my will, but your will, Lord. My will, I don't want my day to go how I want it. I want God to send me my day. Because typically when I ask the Lord to send me my day, he gives me a happy day. He gives me a pleasant mindset. He gives my son a good temper. I'm not like stressing out. And even if I do catch myself slipping throughout the day, I catch it and I'm just like, Lord, help me with this day. Lord, calm Grayson down, calm mommy down, give me a good mindset. Like, you know, you just got to call on him and ask him to help you, because like the good book says, ask and you shall receive, seek and you shall find, knock and the door will be open to you. And I'm not trying to come on here and all the time and preach to you guys, but I'm just letting you guys know what it is in the truth. And that's what it is, you guys. You literally have to ask the Lord to take away that depression from you. And that depression will lead to something else. You're wanting to help with your depression. What do people seek for when they are depressed? They seek for depressants such as alcohol, such as, you know, something to get your mind off of it, whatever that depressant reliever is, which is not a reliever because it actually makes your symptoms worse. It just mellows you out for the moment, but then guess what? Your problems are back. You're still a mom. You still got to take care of your business and take care of your kids. So don't let the devil tamper on your mind, because our minds are a sacred thing, you guys. Your mind is the devil's playground, and he will play with you, and he will play with you. So you have to talk to people about what you're going through. I talked to my mom. Mom, oh, I just want a drink of wine. I just want to just realign and to relax and wind down at the end of the night with a glass or two of wine. Like, Lord knows that's something I struggle with. Not saying I was ever alcoholic or I'm an alcoholic. God forbid, no. But I do like a glass of wine every blue moon, and that's something I'm trying to fight off if I'm trying to live a good life and be a Christian. You can't backslide, and you can't slip up and just have a little taste here and there, because that little taste you're gonna remember, and then you're gonna want that feeling again, and then you're gonna keep going for that taste, and then next thing you know, you're gonna be hooked on having your glass of wine every single night with a nice dinner or whatever, and you're gonna start supplementing breastfeeding for formula feeding, because I strictly breastfeed, and you can't breastfeed and drink. I mean, you could pump and dump, but I feel like that's wasting. My milk is liquid gold, honey, and I'm not about to waste a single drop. So you better believe I gotta shake that demon off real quick. So whenever you guys are feeling like you're being sucked in, you better call on the name of Jesus. I'm not even kidding, because God, he can fight any battle for you. He will be there with you whenever you just feel like breaking down, crying. You guys, trust me, I just want to curl in a ball sometimes and just cry on the floor, because I feel like I'm deserted. Like, I don't have friends like that, you know what I mean? I'm just at my house, I'm not working right now, I'm a stay-at-home mom. I'm not used to this life. I'm not about that stay-at-home mom life, but guess what? I am about it, because that's what I'm doing. Because right now I don't have a choice. I do have a choice, but I choose my kids. I choose to breastfeed and do that whole jazz and stuff like that. So, and bonding with my babies, that's what I'm doing right now. So, by the grace of God, he gave my boyfriend a good income to take care of us. So that's what we're doing at the moment. But I'm the type of person where I like to go out and mingle and talk and get to know people. I'm a people person for the most part. So that's me. So being home all day, it will depress you, and you have to just talk to your friend, talk to your mom, and just get that company, watch a YouTube video, watch something funny to get your mind out of that depressant mode. Shake it. Because if you just sit there and let your thoughts devour you, you're going to neglect your kids. I find myself sometimes on social media just like going, and my son is just like right next to me. I'm just like looking at social media, like when I'm just over it and just like irritated, and then he'll just grab my hand or he'll just put my hand on his face, and I have to just stop and look at my baby and put my phone down. Like, look, I'm missing. I don't want to miss a single thing. I don't want to miss my kids growing up. I don't want to miss seeing my baby smile for the first time. You know what I mean? So it's like you have to stay prayed up. You guys, I'm not even joking. Stay prayed up. And I'm not a saint, God forbid. You know, I'm asking like, oh, all I do is pray and I don't drink, you guys. I'm a bit, no, because trust and believe, I've been there. I mean, I have two kids out of wedlock, so I know what it is. I've been to the club quite a few times, so I know what it is. But I'm trying to be a better person for myself, and the world needs better people. So let's encourage and empower each other together, you guys. If you guys are experiencing the postpartum depression, or if you're pregnant and experiencing depression, because I went through that too, reach out to me, email me, send me an email, Facebook me, Instagram me, you guys. Talk if you have no one to talk to, because I'm here all day at home. So I will respond. So, I mean, if you guys just need someone to talk to, I'm here, because I've been there. And yeah, I didn't go into too much depth on postpartum depression, because that was just kind of my story and how I've been, what I've been going through and how I overcome it by praying and talking to others, like talking to my mom about how I feel. She'll just help me, or talk to someone. If you don't have anyone to talk to, watch a video, watch a movie, watch something funny, something to get your mind off of it. And just look at your baby. Just look at your baby and just be like, man, like, what always pops in my mind when I look at my kids and I'm going through it, I'm like, look, you didn't ask to be here. That was something, a choice that I made by, you know, having unprotected sex, and a baby came out of it. So I got to woman up and do what I got to do for my kids and just let them know mommy is here for them. I'm here for my kids. So you got to be there too for your kids, ladies. Let's woman up and fight that depression, you guys. Shake it off. Call on the good Lord in the name of Jesus, and he will help you through it all. I'm not even joking. He will help you. And if you need a friend to talk to, I'm here. Go ahead and email me. I will put my email information down below so you guys can have someone to talk to. But don't get sucked into that deep, dark hole. Because once you're in it, it's hard to shake it. And it's not pretty. So I hope this video helped you guys, gave you some tips on how I overcome and how I've been shaking off my postpartum depression. I know it hasn't hit me to its fullest ability yet, and sometimes postpartum depression doesn't hit everyone. But if you can feel it creeping on you, like feeling yourself going into depression mode, like you don't want to go anywhere, you don't really want to even be bothered with your kids, you just want to sit by yourself and do your own thing, just close your eyes and be like, Lord, help me. Please take away this feeling. Take away my mindset, Lord God. You know what I'm going through. You know that I don't want to feel this way. This is not me. And I kid you not, he will help you. He will take it all away. So thanks guys for watching. Please don't forget to like this video, thumbs up my video, and subscribe to my channel, please. It'll help me out a lot. Yeah, and I will see you guys in the next video. So thanks so much for watching. I love you all, and I will talk to you guys soon. Bye, guys.